You need to understand, people of God. The church start out very good. I wonder if you all getting what God is saying this morning.
Yeah.
It might be a little lengthy, you know, people of God, but you better take it.
Amen.
You find my God Almighty. These people start out very good with the Lord Jesus Christ, the one that died on the cross of Calvary. Because you need to understand, we have to be very careful, you know. Nowadays, people will even look at you and tell you that they are Jesus Christ. They don't care. Especially some of these, especially the cultist church, them. They will tell you straight up that they are Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And people of God, you need to get and understand, my God Almighty. In the midst, my God Almighty. In the midst of everything, all is going well. Oh, they have the zeal for God. And they are praying. I'm going to tell you how things can come in. Listen very keenly how these things happen. And they're there praying and everything going good and name it and what have you. And they see, my God Almighty, that, you know, if you notice, I want you all to get this. Different from some church that will have their big crusade and name it and what have you. Now I am talking about a building that, my God Almighty, probably can hold 60 to 70 or 80 people, name it and what have you. And you know they are there and the power of God moving and God is using them to heal, deliver, set free. As they said, Jesus, somebody, you see signs and wonder happen in the eyes, in your eyes. Come on, people. Right there in the midst of your eyes, you see signs and wonder happen. And my God Almighty, they see the church start to get full and people come in and what have you. Instead of, my God Almighty, they continue doing what they're doing. They take their mind, listen to this, they take their mind from off the work that is going on and start to look at how the people them getting plenty and the money is not enough. Come on, talk to me now, people. We're having a lot of people, but we're not getting a lot of money. And this place needs to extend more. Come on, talk to me. We have to get another place. And even so with some, listen to this. When the power of God is moving and people see signs and wonder, miracle, name it, one of you, they start to give in. And when they look, my God Almighty, and see all the place getting full, and they're saying, but this place is too small, we need to get a bigger place. Two things they start to focus on. The money and the crowd. Come on, people. Nobody not. They take their mind from off Jesus Christ. Come on, talk to me. The healer, the balmer, the true physician. Because right there, something snap them in their spirit for them to believe that is them doing the work. Have mercy, God help me. And right there, right, what do you think happened, people of God? They decided to get a different building, get a different place. Remember, some of them don't ask God, you know. I want you all to get this in your spirit, you know. I said some of them don't ask God, they take up things on their self. They don't ask God if they are to move or not. And let me say this to you all. I'm going to tell you straight up now. I wonder if evangelist listening this. I wonder if evangelist listening this. It's a reason why I'm calling you. Don't know if you're hearing. In the midst, because miracle signs and wonder going on, You need to get and understand, people of God. A person that God has anointed to do this work. You have to be so careful that this power of God is in operation. And you have the spirit of discernment. The Holy Ghost is intact. Because from the moment you slip off that, the devil will send a witches or a warlock into your congregation. Come on, talk to me now. I'm going to tell you how these things can start. The witches, my God Almighty, are the warlock that come in. They will come in, my God Almighty, with a false sickness. Come on, people, talk to me now. The moment they come with a false sickness, they come to test because they see a loophole to come in. Because I rise up to tell you, if you are operating under the oracle of God, from the moment a witches or a warlock enter, the power of God must lift up a standard. And if the power of God don't lift up a standard, they know right there, said, yes, I got this one. This one is off track. And they bring their sickness come there. And you, dear my God Almighty, trying, listen to this. You, dear my God Almighty, trying to operate with a different spirit, flesh, not the spirit of God, no, flesh. Because if it's a witch come before you and say they're sick, pretending to be sick or whatever, look sick, name it, I say they're mad, whatever. And you, dear my God Almighty, have the power of God. The spirit of God is going to lift up a standard. Come on, talk to me. And from the moment the spirit of God can't able to lift up a standard, you all need to get and understand what God is saying right now. Another spirit ready to operate, flesh. And right there, my God Almighty, I want to tell you something. The person that come in the midst will pretend that they even get ill. I want you to get what I'm saying, you know, people of God. They pretend that they pretend to get ill. I want my God Almighty for my sister to hear this, you know, because this is how certain things start. From the moment they start to pretend, so they get ill when it's not God heal them. That spirit, my God Almighty, take over the person that is in operation. Because what happened right there? The power of God showed that it is not there. And because the power of God showed that it is not there, that person easy well becomes powerless. Because they take their mind from off the work, from off Jesus, and from off my God Almighty, the Holy Spirit. Come on, people. And you know what start to happen now? In the midst of them being home, the demons start to visit them and give them dream of great things that they are doing. Come on, talk to me now. I'm in the realm. They dream see themselves, my God Almighty, doing great deliverance. They dream see themselves doing this, and they dream, listen to this, they even dream see this, rokosata raka soto rokusandalabakunde. The witches them appear in the dream like angel to them, and they accept them. They accept that they accept them in the dream. They start start to operate with a different spirit. And then, my God Almighty, what happened? These spirits start to visit them and talk to them and tell them exactly what they want, because these spirits take them over. I wonder if you all hear what I'm saying. This is how many of these people start out. Roboshate, I feel the Holy Ghost. This is how these people start out with Jesus and being taken over with other spirit. I hope you listen clean to what God said, you know, people of God. I don't have no time to lie. I'm in the realm. They take their mind when they see the crowd and when they see the money. They take their mind from off God and they start to focus on the crowd and the money and want to get a bigger building. And it's all about the money, all about the money, all about the money. And in the midst of them getting a bigger building, what do you think happened right there, people of God? You need to understand what happened right there. The devil is in full operation with whoever. And right there in the midst of dream, demons start to talk to them and tell them what they require. Come on, talk to me, talk to me. And telling them, look, this one takes some blood sacrifice. And they and what happened? They're in meeting, you know, having organization meeting. Come on, talk to me. And in the midst of them having their meeting, you know what happened right there, people of God? Jesus Christ have mercy. The demon, my God Almighty, that take them over, the witches and the warlocks that take them over, is requesting from them blood sacrifice. And they are telling them, look, you see that sister? She don't have no prayer life. You don't know what she's doing. I follow them. I go home with them. I see, Rabba Shataya! Maku Shekeya Mama Kunda. I see the way they live. This one have boyfriend. You don't know that, huh? Uh-huh. And you want to understand this? The very tongue that they used to speak that come from the element of heaven. The tongues turn into language. I wonder if you hear what I'm saying. And the tongue turn into language. You know what happened right there? The demon and them start to correspond. Because demon people of God, they don't speak my God Almighty tongues like my God Almighty heavenly tongues. They speak language. Demon language. And the speak they start to speak. Let me tell you something. In the midst of a cultist organization, whenever the leader is going wrong, you find many of those that is going dear catch that spirit and start to speak language instead of tongues. And they that are dear, the ones them that are dear that know Jesus and know Jesus for themselves, they can know that something is wrong and it will even bother some of their spirit. They will understand, my God Almighty, that they speak language, but they are not feeling the power of God. They are only getting a forces. The tongues come with a force. Heavenly language come with power from on high. Tongues come with a force from the witches and the warlock them. Come on, people. Right dear my God Almighty, what you think happen? The people in the midst of the congregation, when my God Almighty, the witch or the warlock stand up, that is in position for them.
Yes.
When they started to chant and do whatever they're doing, you need to understand what happened. They are placing spell over the people them. In the midst of the night. These are the time when they, my God Almighty, take control over the congregation. When they go into their dark places. And let me tell you something. Into places like those, people of God, they can't too deal with the natural life. All you can see in there is candle. Because the demon want darkness. There are times when them have to have the room very dark too. Dark. And let me tell you something. I want to tell you all I'm teaching through the Holy Ghost right now. I'm teaching through the Holy Ghost right from ever since. But I'm very deep right now. Come on, people, I'm deep. When they, my God Almighty, have the room dark, that call for death. Come on, talk to me. I said, whenever the demon require from them to have the room dark, it's time for somebody to die. It's time for somebody to die. You know what happened, people of God? You want to hear the next story? You all want to hear the next story? Can you all get this in your spirit? I wish if everybody is listening. I don't know who is sleeping, but God help who want to sleep. I'm deep in the room. If it's a husband and wife, that is a witch or a warlock, they have to stop have sex with each other. They cannot have sex with each other. All them sexual thing cut off. Because what? Satan becomes the husband for the witches, and the warlock becomes the father. Satan becomes the father for him. He becomes the father. And you need to get and understand, people of God. The only person must have operation with sex is Satan. Come on, talk to me. You'll be surprised to know Satan sex them. You find, my God Almighty, listen to this. Husband and wife can't sleep, my God Almighty, together anymore. They must have a separate room for each other. If the husband don't know what is going on, the wife is going to tell her, this is what God requires of me. He tell me not to have sex anymore. I don't have the urge. I don't have the urge for sex. That time it's a lie. I said that time it is a lie. Because her body belongs to say Robo Kotoria Bakuturia Kande Bebe City. Our body fully belongs to Satan. Only him alone can have sex. Only him alone can ravish that body. Come on, talk to me. You need to understand, people of God. Witches and warlocks, husband and wife that live together, they cannot have sex with each other from the moment they've been taken over by Satan. The wife belong to Satan, the man belong to Satan as a son. Come on, people. And Satan what Satan will do, if when that man needs sex, he will send in one of his agents to have sex with the man. Come on, talk to me. As long as the man is in the organization, I know what is going on. Come on, talk to me, people. Y'all might think it's a book I'm reading. So right there, people of God, the two of them has been taken over by Satan. I want you all to get and understand what I'm saying. They have to, my God Almighty, be in the midst of their meeting. When it come on to, my God Almighty, 2:33 in the morning. Come on, people, talk to me. Those time in the morning, they meet together. All the witches and the warlock, them all over the world, they meet together, people of God, in a very huge place. Just as how you would see the picture sometime, where they would have, my God Almighty, Jesus and them, have all the angels them gather around. Come on, talk to me. You would have, my God Almighty, the main Dan, which is Satan. Come on, talk to me now. Satan appear himself to them. Just as all Rabba Kuturia Basata Rebekende, Satan appear himself to them like a human being. Come on, talk to me, people. They see Satan with their very, very eyes. He don't appear to them, my God Almighty, like just a spirit. Come on, talk to me. And when they all gather in the realm, I want you all to get what I'm saying right here. The spirit of witches and warlock cover them. They don't look proper. Come on, talk to me. When they gather together, they gather, people of God, the spirit of hatred, anger, every God Almighty wicked spirit that you and I can imagine or think that will operate, my God, in the midst of God's people. These are the spirit that is in them. Yes. And every one of them have their books and their pen. Come on, talk to me. And they are looking, my God Almighty, in the midst of their gathering. They have a big scream, look like a television. Rabba Kotoria, Baba Kotoria, Masende. And whoever they hear me not, even like my very self that is in warfare and whatever I'm doing, they capture, my God Almighty, whatever, and they see me marching and tramping and pulling down. And they are saying, they say, Satan said, I need somebody that can go and attack that woman. You all think, my God, let me tell you something, people of God. The natural is not easy and the spiritual worse. So if many people believe that they can play with with God and even having certain sanctuary and want to play with God, mixed spirit will come in and take over. Come on, talk to me. Especially some people that taking upon themselves talking about them is prophet, and God did not give them prophet spirit. Come on, talk to me. Right there, my God and mighty Satan know who to fill up with his spirit. Come on, talk to me. And right there, you need to understand they are going to my God Almighty sin. Someone that very fierce believe that they can attack that person. Because you need to understand Satan, my God Almighty, operate like Solomon, that have many wives. Come on, talk to me. Like how Solomon used to operate with many wives. But it's just that, my God Almighty, he's in the demonic. That's where these things come from, you know, people of God. I wonder if you all get what I'm saying. It's Jesus Christ that come in and make a difference, you know. I want you all to get that. Cut it out. Cut it out. So right there, people of God, you find my God Almighty, when they gather in their meeting weekly, they are gathering to aim at a mighty, powerful man or woman of God.
Amen.
Their meeting, like God Almighty, is to pull down, tear down, kill. You know what he said? The Bible said he come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. When he send them out, that's what he go for. Let me tell you something. In the midst of my God Almighty, every witches and warlock, they have Satan visit them like me and you. Come on, talk to me. People of God, these people see Satan with their very eyes. They see Satan with their very, very eyes. You think it's a joke? Because what you need to understand, Satan own them. Them don't own Satan. No witches own Satan. Satan own them. Satan don't give nobody. You see, the Lord God Almighty said, listen to what God said. God said, you belong to him, and you can say, I belong to God and God belong to me. Satan don't play that game.
Right.
He alone run things. Because in a quick and a second, he will kill you if you do any form of sleeping up with him.
Right. Yes.
And as I said, the people that Satan target for things like these are the ones them with the mark of Jesus Christ that has been chosen with the very from the very foundation of the mother's womb. Why you think many pastors, my God Almighty, lose their church and my God Almighty is not doing the work of God anymore? Why you think pastors has been taken over in homosexual? Why you think pastors has been taken over doing, my God Almighty, all kind of things? Come on, talk to me, people.
Amen.
These are the things that causes these things to happen. These are the things that cause these things to happen. Because right there, my God Almighty, he's looking for somebody that have zeal. The ones them that don't have zeal, he's looking to turn them worthless. And to also, my God Almighty, have them to put them in big position so that they can use them to spread the disease of homosexual, thief, liar, name it, people of God, whatever, name it. Name it. And what he do? He takes care of them. Satan, my God, listen to me. In the midst of bank, let me jump back into the bank. In the midst of banks, Satan own the banks them. I wonder if you all hear what I'm saying. Many people that are rich and don't have a calling on their life, Satan go in and kill them. Robo shata raba kuturia masende. And when he kill them, that money belong to the satanic organization. Come on, talk to me. I said that all those millions, billions belong to the say Robocotoria Basata, the Holy Ghost is in the midst. Thank you, God. All those money belong to Satan. Why you think, my God Almighty, the music industry so evil? Satan control the music industry. And in the one or two of them that try to get out, if they just try to get out just like that, they're doomed. There's a way of escape for every one of them that is in the Illuminati, you know, people of God. I said there's a way of escape for every one of them that is a witches and a warlock.
Amen.
Everybody, everyone that you see working witchcraft and obia, there's an escape for them, but the only way is Jesus Christ. And because Jesus Christ know the heart, the thoughts and everything, he will back them. He will back you. He will back whoever want to get out of it. But they have to, my God Almighty, focus in the midst of Jesus. And let me say this to your people of God. If it's a situation where God himself come for you, know that, my God Almighty, you are going to go through a lot of hell. But in the midst of going through the lot of hell, you will be surprised to know God is going to back you.
Amen.
Why you think when I, let me talk about, can I talk about myself a little when I just got saved?
Amen.
When I just got saved, people of God, I have never seen this before. I wasn't saved. And the Holy Spirit showed me that something happened to me from when I was a small child. Parents don't know about it, but there's a demon that has messed with me. Come on, talk to me. And you find, my God Almighty, this demon is a dog demon. When I happen to, my God Almighty, start serving the Lord Jesus Christ, I realize, and what happened, it is somebody, listen to this, it is somebody that take me as a little baby and let dog lick my vagina, lick me, come on, talk to me. Put that wicked, my God Almighty, spirit on me. That is the reason why I told you all that when I was a young girl in my 9-10, we have a little puppy dog, my God Almighty, at the house in the country. And all in my intention one day is to hold down that dog and have sex with the dog. But every time I try to hold the dog on, with the dog would fight with me. Come on, talk to me. And thank God for Jesus. You all, you see, people of God, I'm delivered and set free. And I want you all to get what I'm talking about. And I am, listen to me, I am not afraid. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ to speak what God wants me to speak to help somebody. I'm not. So whoever hear these things, I want to say, Lord Jesus, why she have to talk those things? She bring in disgrace on the family. I bind that up in Jesus' name. Fire. I fire that up in Jesus' name. And people of God, you all need to get and understand my God Almighty. When I got saved at the age of 39, you all need to get and understand, people of God, from the moment I give my life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Because I tell you how I got saved, and it was nobody pray for me. It's nobody laid the hands on me. It's the Lord God Almighty coming to that basement place in New York City. Come to get me. And right through the time, people of God, for maybe about a year. I want you all to get. For about a year, as often as ever when I dream, dog and demon coming to get me. Never used to operate that much on me when I was out in the world. Because when I was out in the world, what you all need to understand, my God Almighty, used to happen to me. I used to, my God Almighty, hallelujah, have to be changing partner like you're changing your clothes. Come on, talk to me. Because that sexual spirit was upon me. Come on, people. I have been cursed. And all these things. You see, let me tell you something, people of God. God don't make mistakes, you know. You think he could have somebody as simple to stand and preach and teach these things? Sometimes when people ask some of your questions, you lock your mouth like something catch your tongue. Ooh. People of God, I said, so many nights, my God Almighty, this demon come in. And when these dog come, they just tear at me and I just get up and go and give them my body. Sometimes you want to see some place where they carry me, some nasty, dirty place. Demon would, my God Almighty, just stand up and look at me. I remember a man just stand up looking at me and winding up himself, and right there I'm getting the sex. And I wasn't on him. He wasn't on me. I was all the way over a corner sitting down. And right there, my God Almighty, the demon having sex with me. But with the dogs, none of them don't have sex with me. What they do? Jesus Christ, have mercy. God showing me something now. God showing me something. Let me make a correction. All these years, since I got saved, I am saying that is listen to this, what I'm saying all these years since I got saved, I'm saying it came to my spirit. Not going to say God tell me, but it came to my spirit. That is when I was a baby, somebody do these things with me with dog. The Lord, the Holy Ghost just make a correction. The Holy Ghost just make a correction, people of God. Because all these years when I got saved, I got it that it came in my spirit. That is when I was a baby, it happened. The Holy Ghost said no. In the midst, my God Almighty, of me having sex with men. Listen to this. The Lord said, my God Almighty, one of the men that I have sex with was dealing with a woman that was having sex with a dog. Yeah. all stay there. You all stay there. You better thank God for the glory of God. Thank Him. You know how many people today are going through these things?
Yes.
I tell you that many times. It's not somebody. It's not that you do. You yourself don't have to go and have sex with a dog. From the moment somebody deal with it, is that spirit transferred to you? And this is what the Holy Ghost show me right now. Because all this time I thought from way back, that is what, because that's what came in my spirit.
Amen.
So God making a correction now, because you know what? This is a revolution teaching against the demon organization that went march down their plan.
Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Write that down, minister. Write that down. Revolution teaching against the demon organization that is going to march down their plan. People of God, the Lord God Almighty said it's somebody that I have sex with. I have sex with that man, and that man was dealing with a woman that was having sex with a dog. And she was having the dog licking her vagina, so that's what transferred to me. Come on, people. For months! Some of you wouldn't have the urge to talk these things. Thank God for the apostle. No? Thank God for Robo Shatayama Kunde.
Amen.
Give God glory for the apostle now.
Glory. Yes, God, I mean
business for Jesus. I love him. I love him. I love him. This is all God proved to see if some of us love him, you know. These are some of the way he prove to see if we really love him, because these things must bring glory to him. Come on, talk to me. And people of God, you all need to get a, oh my God Almighty, God show me the man. That same man, my God Almighty, that used to, my God Almighty, take me away as a young girl and have sex with me. That's the same. That's the demon. That's the man that the demon on. And people of God, the reason why the demon them could not attack me. Let me tell you this. Listen to this. The reason why the demon them wasn't attacking me when I was out in the world by having the dog them coming to lick me is because I was sexually active. Come on, talk to me now. But when I stopped being sexually active at the age of 39 until today, for almost one year, dog. One morning I wake up, people of God, and one of the dog come, my God Almighty, and suck me so much that I felt as if my vagina and my womb coming out. All stay there. These things are real. Whether it happen in the realm or happen in the midst of the bed, that time it happened right in the bed. When I wake up, people of God, I grab my vagina and I unk up my knee and I say, Jesus! I shout out. Because it was very painful in the natural. Painful in the natural, and not because I just give my life to the Lord. Listen to this. Many times God allow these things to see if you're going to stay with him or you're going to go back in your vomit. But these things are tests. I wonder if you all hear what I'm saying, people. These things are tests, and you must pass every one of them.
Yes, amen.
And people of God, I believe that was the last time the dog come and did that to me. I wake up, I cry, I start to march around in the house, because remember, God is taking me to be our warrior. And I start to, I say, God, you have to show me how to do what to go about doing this. And he started to give me his word, how to pray. And I started to pray. People have got to start to pray. And all of a sudden, no more dog visit. Come on, talk to me. Give him glory. You need to understand, people of God, when you, my God Almighty, when a person changed, my God Almighty, from being a witch or a warlock, know that Satan is going to come back to get you. Know that if you used to be in a cultist organization, Satan is coming for you. I was one. I was in a cultist organization. That's why he come to get me. I didn't get to the stage of being a witches, but I was practicing, people of God, feeding demon, going to the burying ground, my God Almighty, to throw things in there, get demon to eat. Come on, talk to me. Come on, people. Well, some of you ready to change your mind. No, I can't deal with Apostle because she was a obia worker. I can't deal with her. Why all of you just get quiet all of a sudden like that? I am delivered from that 2000 and what? I think it's from way before I got saved. I delivered from it. I curse out those demons like my God Almighty, a crowbait. I curse them to the ground that they bury in. That's how I've been delivered from them in my sinful stage. And it is God who helped me to do it, even though I was in sin, because he know that his mark is upon me.
Amen.
But many, my God Almighty, suffering I go through. Whenever you're in these things, know that you're going to go through a lot when you get out of it.
Yes.
Because Satan is going to try everything to come and get you.
Right.
And if he don't get you, he's going to have his demon them to torment you.
Right.
But just know that Jesus Christ is going to back you. Because if you have to come and do great work for him, you have to go through some things so that you can tell it to somebody. And people of God, I bear the consequence. All the stuff them that my God Almighty, I get from the cultist organization, like the picture. They talking about they giving me a mother and they giving me a father. When I toss them out in the garbage, that's the way I becomes homeless as well. Come on, talk to me. I have to sleep, my God Almighty, on the building where all kind of insect roach, all kind of insect crawling on me. Come on, talk to me. I've nowhere to sleep because I let these things end up in the garbage heap. So they send me on the garbage cellar. Come on, talk to me, basement. I live on the basement for about 2 months and odd, people of God. I've nowhere to turn. I've money and cannot get a place. Because I was out of the organization. You all need to get and understand. This woman of God don't get anointed overnight. Come on, talk to me. It's not an overnight thing. So all I open the young miss ear my message. She can listen it and say if she want to be like me.
Right.
And I'm telling you, people of God, when I tell you, my God Almighty, that I suffer the consequence. I can't go into those things because it is too many. But what I'm trying to say, in the midst of everything, when I really and truly find Jesus years after, let me tell you how many years after I find Jesus. It's not long after, maybe about two years after I find Jesus. Come on, talk to me. And as I said, when I find Jesus, all these things happen to me. I go to hell. All these things happen to me. I bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. My weather over here is in 60 something. What a blessing. What a blessing. It's been about 3-4 days now. I'm getting that weather. What a blessing. So people of God, I'm trying to say, my God Almighty, that in the midst of these things, when you cross over to Jesus, know that you're going to suffer a lot. But you know the worst thing about life with many? The worst ones them you can find is the ones them that turn to Jesus to be a witches. Come on, talk to me. And warlocks. Those always stuck in their behavior and let it look as if Jesus is still in operation. Because the worst thing that they are doing is mixing and dabbling. Come on, people. They are saying Jesus and know that he's not the power of God. Come on, talk to me. So right there, Satan got them. You know what has to happen to people like those? If they don't decide to return back to the Lord Jesus Christ, what he have to do? Leave them to their rep to be a mine until Satan himself kill them.
That's right, amen.
If they don't decide to go back to their reprobate mind, and the only way it can happen, God have to mash down their organization, leave them powerless, where they don't have the church, they don't have the building, they don't have nothing, and when they see that they are powerless, they either have to call on Jesus or remain in their sin until they die. I wonder if you all hear what God said.
Amen.
Remain in their sin until they die. People of God, whenever you cross over out of these things, it takes a lot of prayer and fasting. Why you think God?